Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, from Tommy Bryant Stadium here at Harry Stewart Field for this game between the visiting Virginia High Bearcats and the Lebanon Pioneers. Big game, playoff implications in this game. Both teams coming in with a 2-5 record, and they are both one game out of the playoff situation. So this game does have a whole lot of implications. Virginia High, of course, dressed in the white with black pants. The Pioneers in their red. Virginia High won the toss, and they elected to receive. Logan Smith will kick off for the Pioneers. Bradley, the running back for the Virginia High, and he's on the far side of the field. One of the short men pick that up, and he gets it up over the 30 to the 35-yard line. That was Michael Bradley who ran that kick back. So pretty good field position for Virginia High at the their own 37-yard line, where they'll have it first and 10. Jamie Farley here on the audio, Ernie Benko on the video tonight for ARC TV. Shotgun there. Gives it off to a running back. That's Howard, the running back. He's knocked down pretty quick, and Michael Howard, he's the tailback, and he'll do most of the running for these Bearcats. He lost about a foot, so it'll be second and 10 for the Bearcats from their own 37-yard line. Once again, Bradley off his right tackle. He picks up a little yardage. He stopped all of a sudden up on the 40. I think that was quit on the tackle there. Third and seven for the Bearcats. Pioneers jumped offside, so big penalty on the Pioneers. They move it up over to the 46, so it's going to be third and about a yard for Virginia High. So big penalty against the Pioneers here early. Once again, there's Bradley, and we get a whistle. Play is stopped. I think we've got an illegal motion against Virginia High.
It's going to be a false start on the offense, so they give those yards right back.
So the yards go back right back. It's third down and six now for Virginia High. Running out of the shotgun and running a spread. They've got two wide receivers either side of the field, as you can see. Bradley drops back. He's looking to throw. He finally gets away. He lays it down the middle, and he's got a receiver down there open at the 25. He was pretty well covered.
Cole Stutes came over Medley again, but wide open down the field was 29, Bobby Medley.
That's Bobby Medley, the one of the ends for Virginia High. So big gain on third and long. Ball's on the Pioneer 23-yard line. Same formation as last. Snap back, Bradley gives it to his running back, Howard, and he takes it down about the 20-yard line. He'll pick up 3 yards on the carry. It will be second down and seven for Virginia High.
That thing about the Pioneers, they played the run well so far, but that big pass play gave the Bearcats an opportunity to score right here inside the red zone.
Virginia High running no huddle there. Ryan Bradley, the quarterback. He gives it off to his running back. That's Howard up the middle. He's got big yardage, and he's tackled down near. He went down just shy of the goal line.
Yards out. He ended up a yard shot touchdown. Big time run. If the Pioneers had played the run well over to that
goal.
First and goal for Virginia High. They're only about a foot away from the guard line. High snap, and it looks like the Pioneers have the ball. So we got a bad snap, and Virginia High turns it over. So big break for the Pioneers. Mark's got on it, so the Pioneers will have it on about the 5-yard line. I believe it's sitting exactly on the 5, so big break for the Pioneers. Virginia High, all said, I'm not sure that snap maybe came early. Bradley might not have been ready for it, but Pioneers jumped quickly on it. Corey Stoots under, he gives to his running back. That's Walker Dillon. He picks up a quick 5 up to the 10. Quick opening play. Dillon in the hole quickly. So it'll be 2nd and 5 for the Pioneers from their own 10-yard line. We're just underway here. 9:15 left in the first quarter. No score. Stoots under center again. One running back. He gives it to his tailback. Dillon again, I think. Big hole, and he gets it up over the 20-yard line. He gets it up to about the 21 or 22-yard line. I think it's on the 22, so he picked up 12 yards on the carry. And that'll be a big first down for the Pioneers.
Rain continues to fall, and you know the Pioneers are going to stick with this ground.
That gets them out from under the shadow of their goalposts. Everybody in tight this time for Lebanon. Again, he gives it. No, Stoots ran a little mix, wrist direction. Miss Stanley's out here. He gets it up over the 25 to about the 27. They ran a little reverse. The lineman between us and the quarterback, I couldn't really see who had it, but he got it out to about the 28-yard line. So it'll be 2nd and 5. Stanley picked up 5 on that one. He might have gotten more like 6.
No score in this one. Bad snap.
Once again, everybody in tight. Oh! Hand off to Dillon. Boy, he's met in the backfield there. Loss of about a yard on that play, and Virginia High is going to take a timeout. Early timeout for the Bearcats. We'll take it with them. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. Okay, it'll be 3rd and 6 now for the Pioneers. They split one receiver out wide to the left in the power eye. Sends a man in motion. That's Stanley. Stoots rolls out to the left. He's got Stanley out here in the flat wide open. He's up over the 40. Gets up near midfield before he's knocked out of bounds. They're going to mark it at about the Pioneer 47-yard line. So quick little short pass to the man in motion. That was Stanley. He caught it and made a nice gain. So another first down for the Pioneers. They're going to mark it at the Pioneer 48. Once again, everybody in tight for the Pioneers. They actually have an unbalanced line. Once again, to the second man through, that's Dillon. He goes down over the 40-yard line. They're going to mark that one down at the Pioneer 39, at the Bearcat 39-yard line. So another first down for the Pioneers. Moving it well after recovering that fumble. Same formation. Everybody in tight. Brick to the fullback. Stanley breaks the tackle. He's down. And he gets down to the end zone. I think he scored a touchdown. No, they say he stepped out of bounds over on the 2 yard line. Big gainer, though. That'll be first and 10 for the Pioneers. I think they're going to mark it on the 3 yard line, I believe. So I think they mark it on about the 4. Evidently, stepped out of bounds before he dove into the end zone.
Stanley caught the senior high, unaware of it, and keying on Dillon.
High formation, Stoops.
Now here's Stoops under center.
Hands off, set his hands through his back to the backfield.
That was a busted play right there. Dillon started to go to the left, and the play was to the right. Had
yeah, that play, something went wrong with that play. Dillon ran right into toward the Bearcats. He's going to lose a yard back to the 5, so it's going to be second and goal from the Virginia High 5 yard line. That looked like a busted play to me. Once again, in the I formation, everybody in tight.
I formation for Stoops. Hands off, second man through. Bounces off the back
side. Bounces off the tackle, gets close to the goal line.
Pioneers say it's in.
Close to the end zone.
Merlin thought he got in. I don't know about this. They're going to mark him.
They're going to mark him on the one. He was really close down there.
Close to me. And again, we're a ways away here.
But anyway, it's going to be third yard for the Pioneers.
About as close as you can go. Look over at that point. They're knocking on the door.
I think we had a special snap.
On the quarterback sneak.
I think Corey Stoops took that ball in. He just got a quick snap and sneaked it in. So touchdown for the Pioneers.
On a 1 yard touchdown for quarterback,
Andy Stoops.
And we'll have an extra point try. So great drive of 95 yards for the Pioneers. I didn't count the number of plays, but they one pass play in there. The rest of it on the ground. So a big opening drive for the Pioneers on their first possession. Dillon will try the extra point. High snap. Kicks down. It's up. And it's good. So, with 5:56 left here in the first quarter, Pioneers lead it 7-8. All right, we're back once again, ready for the kickoff. Bradley and Latham back, and that was kicked on the ground. That man grabs it. Howard gets it at about the 30, gets up to the 36-yard line where he's tackled. And Virginia High will put it in play, first and 10, from their 36-yard line. Once again, Virginia High out of the no-huddle offense. They had the ball down on the one. There was a missed snap, which the Pioneers promptly turned into a 95-yard TD drive. Bradley gives to Howard. He's trying to get wide. Cuts back. Picks up 2 or 3 yards. Not too much, though. Pioneers strung that one out pretty well. He'll pick up a couple on that carry, maybe 3. We'll call it second down and a long 7.
It'll be second about 7. They're going to give him 3 out to about 7. Starting at the 36, giving 3 out to 39.
Bradley looks for the play from the sideline.
Ron Bradley.
Lined up on the right side, double wide outs to the right and to the left. Bradley wants to throw. Back to the 30, throws downfield.
Got a man down the middle wide open again.
Got a man down. No coverage there, and that's going to be a touchdown for Virginia High. Robbie Medley caught that pass down the middle. So that'll be a 61-yard TD strike. So two quick TDs here. Second play Virginia High ran in this series. And Medley just wide open down the middle. Nobody close to him. So, Jay High will try the extra point.
So the Bearcats answer right back with a quick strike for a touchdown.
Jacob Fayer, the kicker,
he
gets it up, and it's good. Pioneers nearly blocked that one, so with 5:05 left in the opening quarter, it's 7 apiece. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. Okay, Fayer will kick off for the Virginia High. We've got freshman Logan Smith back deep along with tailback Dylan. Squibb kick. The ball gets loose. Pioneer had it over there and it got loose. Virginia High got on it, so they try an onside kick and they'll take over at the Pioneer 45-yard line. That ball right in the breadbasket of a Pioneer, but he couldn't hold on to it. So Virginia High gets the ball back in great field position after having scored. I thought the Pioneers had that ball, though. He just couldn't hold on to it. Bradley drops back once again. He's got trouble, and he's thrown for a big loss. He's going to lose about 13 yards on that play.
Girl, that's how they can stop his passing attack.
Pioneers got back there in a hurry. I'm not sure who got the tackle. But anyway, a big loss there for Virginia High. That was second down and about 32 yards to go for a first down, or 22 yards, I'm sorry. Bradley at the 43-yard line, second and 22. Bradley fakes his running back. He keeps it, tries to go off tackle. And I think he's going to lose a little more yardage, I think. Lost a yard after the fake to Howard. So it's going to be third and 23, near as I can count. I've run out of fingers and toes there. I'm not sure how to count that.
Pioneers
realize
they got
a cover. There's a big hit over there after the completion, but my gosh, they picked up a lot of yardage there. Geezer made the catch, and I wouldn't be surprised if Virginia High doesn't go for it now. Because they're about 3 yards short of a first down, I think, at the Pioneer 42-yard line.
Might
give it to Howard right here. Come on, Dave.
Merlin, looking for them to go with the
long
count here and
probably
go with the handoff to Howard.
They've got their play now. They're ready. Once again, Bradley drops back to throw, lays it up over the middle. He made quite a catch down the field. We've got a flag up here. Not sure what that's about, though. We'll see what the flag's about. Clock is stopped. The umpire threw that flag. Holding against Lebanon, so that penalty will be refused. And Virginia High, after that catch, they've got a first down. Not sure where they're going to place it there. They're down about, I think, the 15, 16-yard line. It is the 16, so it'll be first and 10 for Virginia High from that point. That was quite a good catch. Pioneers had people covering, but they were guilty of holding, so they were going to lose. There goes Bradley out running out to the left, and he gets wrestled down there. That's Walker Dillon, got a hold of him, and stopped him for about a yard gain there, I think. Well, it's still at the 16, so Bradley gained nothing on that play. 7-7, 2:24 left here in the first quarter. Virginia High knocking on the door again, though. Second and 10. Bradley rolling out. Throws it down into the end zone. That one's batted away. He threw a little jump ball down there. He's got the big receiver out there. He just threw up a little jump ball, but that one was batted away.
Stanley were over there. Number 11, Randy Bostick as well. All three of those guys right in the area.
So it's 3rd and 10 now for the Bearcats from the Pioneer 16-yard line.
If you're the Pioneers, you've got to be mindful of the pass. They're gonna look for some of these guys, especially the tall guy, 6'5", Medley. Got to find him because he's going to throw it up to him.
Bobby Medley on the left side with Dixon.
Medley about 6'5", out there as a wide receiver. Gives it off to Howard. He runs right, but they string him out. He may have picked up a yard. That's about it. So it'll be 4th and 9 for Virginia High.
Chris thought that Howard could get him enough yardage, but he's going to go through there right here, you would imagine.
I'm not surprised. It's 4th and 9. I'm sure Virginia High will put it up here. 1:35 left here, first quarter. We're tied at 7. Bradley back. He throws it over here in the corner. He throws a nice pass. Battle for the ball. And it came loose. His wide receiver went up there for it, but Logan Smith there, freshman Logan Smith, batted that one away, so the Pioneers hold. And after the onside kick, Virginia High threatens but fails to score. So the Pioneers will take over on their own 15-yard line. This is their second possession of the game. Of course, had that 95-yard drive their first possession. They come out in the power eye. Give it to the fullback. That's Stanley. And he goes off the left side. He'll get up to about the 19-yard line, I think. Picks up about 3 yards on the quick hitter. It'll be 2nd and a short 7. I believe we're calling 2nd and 6. Stanley picked up pretty good yardage. Pioneers getting pretty good blocking down there in that offensive line so far tonight. Hands off to Travis Dillon. He gets outside and looks like he was going to have a little running room, but good defensive play over there on the right. He gets it up just over the 20-yard line. So it'll be 3rd down and about 4 for the Pioneers.
Ben Long came up with a big play last week through the air. Ben Long's over here towards us.
The right in the I formation.
3 wideouts this time for the Pioneers. And a throw out to the man in the flat here, but that pass was well overthrown. So the Pioneers will face a 4th down, and they'll send Logan Smith, that senior Logan Smith, or tight end Logan Smith, will do the punting for the Pioneers. Lathrop is back at midfield to receive this punt.
Await the punt from the 21-yard line.
Oh, they're going to end up in pretty good field position right here. That
ball hits back here on about the 35, and it's going to roll down to about the 22-yard line of the Pioneer. Boy, Logan Smith really boomed that one.
All the way down to the 32-yard line.
he got about close to 60 yards on that punt. That was quite a punt. But that will end the first quarter. Our score is 2-8, 7 apiece. We'll be back with more. You're watching high school football on ARC TV.
Well, that's the end of the first quarter. We'll play 7-7 tie.